We're told that each square below represents one whole. So this square is a whole, this is another whole, so together that's two. And then we have something less than a whole. And they say what decimal is represented by the shaded area? So it's going to be two and then something. So it's going to be 2 point something. And let's think about what we have over here. This is one whole, two wholes. And then over here, we've taken a whole and we've divided it into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 equal sections. So we've divided it into tenths. Each of these bars is equal to a tenth. And we have 7 of them shaded in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this right over here is 7 tenths. So this is going to be 1, 2, and 7 tenths. So if we wanted to write it as a mixed number, we'd write it as 2 and 7 tenths. But they say what decimal is represented by the shaded area? So instead of writing 2 and 7 tenths, we could write 2.7. Because the space immediately to the right of the decimal points, that's the tenths place. So we have two ones, two wholes right over here, and then we have 7 tenths. This is the tenths place. And we could check our answer, and we got it right. Let's do another one of these. So same thing, what decimal is represented by the shaded area? So we have three wholes, and then this whole is divided into tenths. Now it's divided into these vertical bars. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 vertical bars. They're equal, so there it's divided into tenths, and we've shaded in 5 of them. So this one over here is 5 tenths. So it is 3 wholes and 5 tenths. So it's gonna be 3 wholes, and in the tenths place, we would put 5. 3.5, 3 wholes and 5 tenths. We can check our answer. Got it right. Let's do a few more of these. What decimal is being represented by the shaded area? So over here, let's see, I have 100 squares. You see I have 10 columns, and each of them have 10 squares in it. So 10 times 10 is 100. So I have 100 squares here, equal squares, so I've divided it into hundredths, and I've shaded in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of the hundredths. Hundredths. So how do I represent that? So 0, that's the ones place, that's the tenths place, and now I'm in the hundredths place, and so this we have 9 of the hundredths shaded in. So this right over here would be 9 hundredths, which is exactly what we have there. All right, let's do one more of these. All right, well, it's the same thing. We have 2 of the hundredths filled in. So I'll write 0. If I did that, that would be 2 tenths. That's not what we have filled in. We have 2 hundredths filled in. So this is 0.02, and we're done.